just take it from here. And these are the Teleco examples. So I start with the ETSI MANO. So that's the well-known reference architecture of ETSI NFV, Network Functions Virtualization. And the MANO itself stands for management and orchestration. So all these kind of brains and controllers are grouped under the name MANO. So MANO has the VIM, the infrastructure management, the VNFM, VNF manager, and the NFVO. So the VIM is typically the, for example, something like VMware, like OpenStack. And in draft versions for ETSI NFV, it can be Kubernetes as well. And the VNFM is a functional block that takes care of the lifecycle management of the VNF. And I will show that, well, this is not a webinar of ETSI NFV, but I will show that in the orchestration flows. And then we have the NFVO. So guys, please now start with me to think. I told you about the main bricks of the orchestration. So now when I tell you about the repositories that's included in the NFVO, maybe now it starts to make more sense. So in the NFVO, we have the NS catalog. So yes, we have a catalog that includes all the network services modeled in that NFVO. We have the VNF catalog. So we have a catalog of all VNFs that are to be onboarded. And we have the NFV instances. Like if you instantiate a VNF, you will see it here as a VNF record. If you instantiate a network service, you will see it here as an NFV instance. And you have the NFVI resources. Like for example, if the NFVO manage 10 DCs, then each DC, you will know from the NFVO that each DC include, for example, 15 server with number of CPUs, how many of them are utilized and how many of them are available for new services. So that actually match the catalogs, that actually match the inventory that I talked about. And inside the NFVO, you have the closed loop control and you have the also any kind of NFVO or a solution. You can have also the design time environment. And NFVO have a northbound interface with a generic block called OSS BSS. This maps to any northbound of the NFVO. And that northbound can be even an orchestrator, but in another domain. It can be a service orchestrator. So if you ask me now, NFVO, is it an orchestration in the resources domain or service domain or customer domain? Then I'll tell you confidently, NFVO from standards perspective, it is an orchestrator in the resources domain. It takes care of the cloud resources, of the VNFs on the cloud. However, it doesn't take care of the service. Let me give you one clear example. If you are hosting a VNF, an IMS VNF that is actually participating in a voice over LTE or voice over Wi-Fi service, if the VNF is misbehaving on the CPU level or a virtualization level, that's the responsibility of the NFVO to scale or heal. But what if the quality of the service as a voice over Wi-Fi has been degraded? For example, the success ratio of the calls, or maybe the voice clarity of the call itself. This is out scope of the NFVO because it doesn't see the real service, okay? I picked two flows from ETSI NFV. One is the VNF instantiation, and one is the VNF scaling, okay? So I will not go into the bits and bytes of each message, but I will go on to explain the theme of the flow. So you have the NFVO, you have the VNFM and the VIM, and that's the main bricks of the MANO, like NFVO, VNFM, and VIM. And you have the VNF that's going to be onboarded and the EMS, that's the element management function doing the FCAPS thing, like fault management, configuration management, accounting, performance and security. So let's say the instantiation starts from the NFVO. Either it is triggered by northbound system or by an administrator. So the request goes to the VNFM from the NFVO, instantiate VNF request. So it's some sort of capability of the order management. So you put the order to the VNFM. Regardless what the VNFM is doing, that's very ETSI NFV internal like related process. Like it creates something called VNF LCM operation occurrence, and then respond back to the API by accepted. And then it does something important. Step six, you see that VNFM is sending a grant request to the NFVO. As if VNFM is asking NFVO, please I want to instantiate the VNF, and these are the resources required, and these are the constraints, and these are the limitations, blah, blah, blah. So the first question, how did the VNFM knew the resources required and the constraint and the limitation? The answer is the VNFM has access to the VNF catalog. So it knows the modeling of the VNF and it knows the requirement of the VNF. That's number one. Number two, why it is asking the NFVO for granting? Because NFV orchestrator is doing resource orchestration. So he's the one who sees the resources end to end and he sees the utilization. And maybe as a result of this request, he can tell the VNFM, no, do not instantiate because there are no enough resources. Or no, I have a policy that maybe that mandates that you at the VNFM do not do that. So it's always mandatory and recommended actually to consult the NFVO before doing any kind of lifecycle management, before doing instantiation, before doing scaling, before doing healing, because that's the brain of the NFV or telco cloud environment. So once the request is granted in step 7, in step 8, the VNFM communicate to the VIM. You can say it like OpenStack, for example, and communicate with OpenStack to bring up the VMs and the connection between the VMs. So again, the question, how did the VNFM knew that I need to instantiate this number of VMs, the VM flavors, the interlocks, all these are the VNF descriptor in the VNF catalog. And then once the VNFM does the resource allocation, and once the operation is finished, the VNFM notify the NFVO that the VNF is up. Why? Because NFVO will have to update the inventory that now we have a VNF record with this kind of resources utilized. So you see, it's a mix of catalog, inventory, and closed loop control. And then once the VNF is up, you put the day zero configuration, you communicate with the EMS to do the day one configuration. So that's an example of an instantiation. What will be more interesting will be the scaling. So in scaling, there are a lot of tens of triggers that can be used to trigger scaling. But I picked one of the standard approaches that VNFM is having some sort of relation with the VNF, asking the VNF to it's some sort of a model of subscription. Like, for example, the VNFM subscribe to certain parameters on the VNF, okay? And these parameters either periodically sent from the VNF to VNFM, or whenever a threshold is crossed in the VNFM is notified. So that's the monitoring artifact that was defined in the VNF descriptor that I explained in one of the slides. This is part of the VNF template, VNF descriptor, that this artifact or this monitoring parameters will be monitored for the sake of lifecycle management. So let's say that this monitoring parameter is, for example, CPU utilization. So VNFM keeps getting information about the CPU utilization. And once the CPU utilization comes to a certain threshold, let's say 80%, VNFM take a decision to scale. So how did the VNFM made such decision? Because this policy is defined in the VNF descriptor that when the CPU reach 80%, you have to scale. So that's a closed loop control thing. We did an instantiation in the first slide. We kept monitoring. We detect a threshold being crossed. We do scaling. So that's a closed loop control, and that's part of the orchestration capability. And then VNFM in 6, as we know, it will ask a grant from the NFVO, can I do this scaling or not? Are there resources or not? Do you have any issues or not? If no issues, then the grant response will be there and VNFM will scale. Most probably it will do scale out. And because there was one discussion about scale out to scale up, like horizontal or vertical scaling, in NFV and Telco Cloud, in VM world, in Telco, we do scale out. We add VMs. We don't do scale up, scale down. We do scale out, scale in.